Jeff and Biden's landmark trillion-dollar infrastructure deal cleared its final hurdle over the weekend and is now on its way to the final passage as soon as this evening, possibly. But an uncertain future lay ahead in the Democratic-controlled House. And joining me now is Stefano DeFray. He's the co-director of the documentary The Day I Had to Grow Up, which focuses on youth activism. Thank you so much for being with us here again on BNC Live. Now, let's start with these. Nice to have you. Let's start with President Biden's bipartisan infrastructure deal. It cleared its final hurdle over the weekend. So when do you think we can expect its passage?
I would say by the end of August, maybe even as close to the middle of August. You know, they have to go through this procedural motion of debating for about 30 hours, I believe, in the Senate. And so they are starting that right now. They haven't taken their August recess. So that's a fundamental investment that I think the Democrats and a small amount of Republicans know that it's going to be a good investment for this country, and the first one really in 50 years at this scale.
Yeah, it's hard to believe so long. Do you think it's a sure thing that the Democratic-controlled House will also approve the bill?
I think that when the upper chamber finishes it, they're going to have to start working immediately on this human infrastructure bill, which is a separate bill that would be $3.5 million, really focusing on child credits, human aspects that really have to do with community colleges, investments in green jobs. And I think that the Republicans are not going to be on board with that one. So I think the most important thing that the Biden administration really wants to focus on is getting this passed through the House. The Democrats do have a majority, but you will start to see in the House some Republicans also join on board, just like we had in the Senate with the 18 Republicans there. So this is really a bipartisan infrastructure deal for $1.2 trillion affecting many, many people in this whole country.
Yeah, it does affect many people. And in fact, when you're talking about people of color, they have been talking about hopefully reversing long-running racial disparities in this country. Does this bill in any way address that?
Yeah, absolutely. So when you think about the people that are going to have the jobs in these countries, in the states that are going to be affected and in the United States, we look at number one, these jobs will be provided with union wages, number one. Number two, you don't have to have a college degree. So the burden of student debt will not affect the individuals who want to partake in this to get good jobs, because we're going to need to employ many, many people at the federal level with all various types of skills. I think the most important thing is I focus on the bill, on the $46 billion affecting Black and brown communities. That affects droughts, it affects wildfires, it affects people who don't normally get federal funding because it's the last thing to happen. The other thing I want to say is broadband internet. There's an infrastructure of about $68 billion, which doesn't sound like a whole lot of money, but it's about 10% almost of the package that will affect rural communities. This will affect Black and brown people because these communities who are in rural parts have to participate in the education system that has now gone to the 21st century, and I believe is fundamental to the investment of our children.
Yeah, Stefan, I'm really glad that you pointed out broadband in the infrastructure bill, because it does affect our children. And in fact, you know, you co-directed a documentary where you focused on youth activism. I'm wondering, do you think there were voices were heard in this bill? Do you think that young people really had a say in the direction this country is moving in?
Well, it's a great question, and it's one I think about very often. In my documentary, The Day I Had to Grow Up, we focus on showing how particularly the influence of activists have affected the scope and the care of the Democratic Party. There is no doubt that activism has affected the policies and the direction of the Democratic Party. And this is a very good thing, because many times as individuals, whether you're young, whether you're from a Black community, a brown community, any real community that doesn't feel that it's part of the political system, it's so important to feel that you have influence. You have some voice, and that voice is going to have an effect on the greater scale. I believe that the activists have fundamentally changed the way that a shaped policy, no doubt in the next one that they're going to try for $3.5 trillion, but this one effectively that will get done, they've had already an effect. And so that's a win for us. That's a win for our children. It's a win for Black and brown communities. It's a win for this entire country to have many more people in our society involved in the decision making.
Well, I love hearing how optimistic you are about this. So let's all keep our fingers crossed that everything goes as planned. Thank you so much for joining us, Stefano. As always, we appreciate you being with us here on BNC.